Hi subscribers and viewers, I want to welcome you back to this wonderful channel, welcome to OWUUBII channel. So in this video, I'm going to do a video on unifi ISP planner. Okay, this software helps you to effectively plan a point-to-point or a point-to-multipoint radio connection, and it's a very vital tool in radio frequency planning in telecommunication. So kindly sit back, relax, and watch me whilst I give you details on how to use this particular tool from Ubiquiti. Thank you and stay tuned. Without wasting time, let's proceed with this video. For you to get the UISP software, you just need to log in, or you need to go onto the Ubiquiti webpage, which is ubnt.com or ui.com. Whilst there, you can navigate to UISP, which is top right here. When you click on it, it brings you to the UISP platform, and then you can see the UISP portal. And so basically what this is supposed to do is to help you with some recommended access points according to your distance and the width you are covering, right? And when you are done, they give you the best device you need, and then you can purchase them for your project. And so let's go to the UISP portal, which is up here. Let's click on it. So it brings us to the particular platform we are going to work on today. Okay, so we are on the platform now. So this is where we are going to do our RF planning, right? Now, there are a couple of coordinates. So example, these are, let's go to some of the features you can find on this particular tool or platform. You have the map, which is this, okay, entire space. You have the topology. You have the device list. After we've selected the devices we are going to use, you have the device list here and the cost of those devices. And then we have the profitability calculator. It tells you how profitable these devices are going to help you in achieving your purpose, right? So let's go back to our map. At this point, this is where we need to configure. So example, I have a point to multipoint idea in mind. So let's first create a point to multipoint. Then later we'll create a point to point between base stations, okay? But this point to multipoint is going to be between access point and stations, meaning master and slave, okay? So let's create our first one here. Okay, so this is our first one. I need to configure a coordinate for it. Okay, so this is our master, okay, and this is the coordinate, but let me generate a unique coordinate I have in mind. So what this tool, this ISP design center, actually does is to try and avoid any obstacle between communicating point to multipoint radios, okay, like communicating between the base station and the station. So let's proceed and create a base station, let's say at a bridge here. Okay, you can always provide a coordinate. You can always provide a coordinate here, a unique coordinate you have, okay? And this is auto. If we change it to manual, you'll be able to change the coordinates, the AP name, okay? So let's say this is my base station. Okay, you can be able to change the type of access point. Okay, you can be able to change it from here. You can type and then it will change. You can change the channel width, the antenna type, the power, the height. Okay, if you come to the station, you can also do the same thing here, right? But if you put it and then it's here, it even tells you the elevation. Okay, it tells you the elevation and the height you need to achieve to have obstacle free point-to-point radio connection. If you walk through the line, it tells you the distance, the line of sight height, and then the Fresnel height it covers. So this is a very good tool. Let's get back to auto. So it's back to auto. This is the device it has been selected for our point to multi-point connection. Okay, so let's now, if we come onto the map, it tells us the coverage of this base station. I mean the radio coming from this base station. So this entire place is being covered. And if you look up here, this is the coverage. This shows the strength of the signal. When it's weak, it starts from being very green all the way to red. Red signifies a very strong signal. Okay, and so depending on your coordinate, you will be able to shift your radio upwards, but make sure it's in the same range of the base station. Okay, if you see red on the connection line, it means there's an obstruction between the base station and the communicating access point or the station. And so this line, this imaginary line drawn here, signifies the coverage of the access point. Okay, it does, but it also tells you the obstacles this connection will go through to get to the next point. And so all you need to do is to get a good line of sight, right? So this is how the point to multi-point access works. So let's create more and try and interlink them so you can understand how ISPs work. On this same point, we can create another access point here which will connect to this. So let me create an access point here, add station. So I've added station here which communicates to this point to point base station here. The key thing is to make sure it's in the same range of the base station. So let's say this is the distance I want to cover. There is an obstruction here, and so I need to get in and understand what the situation is. So there is an obstruction at the station, at the receiving access point. So what do I do? I just need to raise the point up to, you know, some meters. Let's say 90 meters would do. I have my connection now, and this is the speed I'm receiving, which is 232 megabits at the distance of 31.99 kilometers. And I'm using this radio station LTU rocket with sector antenna, and then I have the LTU long range access point here, all from Ubiquiti. Okay, so basically this is how it is. So it tells me the height I've raised it to, the tilt, the azimuth, just like setting up a satellite antenna. And so if you click each line, it's able to tell you into detail. Let me raise this a bit, you know. It tells you into detail how this radio communication can work with the help of this tool and the best recommended radio connection for you. Let me extend this a bit. Okay. All right. So I'm still in. I'm still between the range of the base station. Now let me create another base station here for you to understand how telecommunication is all about. So let me create another one here. Let's say Apedra. Okay, let me create another one at Apedra, which is going to communicate to Assume and then Enyinem. Okay, now there is an issue here, so I need to rectify. You see these red lines, you see, means there is obstruction between this communicating access points, and so the coverage is not even covering the, it's rather concentrating on where it has a free and a good line of sight. And so what I can do is to try and raise the antenna or the pole or whatever to be able to communicate with this access point, which might be difficult, you know, because of the elevation of the land. So I've just done this. Let me see if it works. Let me try this as well. Okay, so I've done that, and this is what I've gotten, but it looks like this is beyond the range of this particular access point. So let me just try and bring it forward to Pramkese. And these are all this is just a test tool. Okay, if you have any coordinates, you can just put it in and then you'll be able to achieve. So here I still have obstacle here, so let me change the location once more. Let me bring it to Chebi. Okay, now I have a clear line of sight here. Let me add another link to it at Asamankese. Add AP. No, this is not what I wanted. Okay. So let me add a point to point here. Okay. So there is obstacle here as well. So let me quickly do the right thing and then I can have my AP communicating perfectly. Okay, so I've done that, but this is more of point to point. Okay, so there is one radio here, so there are about two radios here, and then there is one radio here. Okay, so I've created about two point multi point. Now I'm going to link this point multi point so that I have a kind of a unified network where I can communicate between all access points connected together. So let me just create a point to point link here. So I have, so I have a point to point link here. Okay, connecting from here to here. Okay, so this is my point to point connection between the two base stations, and this is the speed I'm getting on this point to point access points. But I want more than this, so let me quickly get in there and change the access point. Okay, so this is air fiber. Let me change it to the best. I think this is the best. Okay, let me change it to the LA access link cutoff range. Yeah, it cannot go that far. It's not the best access point. So let me get back to my auto so that it gives me the best access point I need for this communication. And so if you watch carefully, we have our coverage now. This is not good. There is an obstacle here. So let me just raise it a bit. Okay, I'm freezing it. This is also not good as well. So let me raise it a bit. Let me raise this side as a bit as well. Okay, so now I have my good connection here. Okay, so it's able to give you the coverage of your signal. See, so it tells you the speed and the height and the coordinates. Okay, so basically this is how this tool works. If we move on to the topology, you'll be able to see in real time connected devices on the tower 2 and tower 3, tower 1 and tower 2. On tower 1, you have 4 devices on the base stations. These are the base stations, right? If you click it further, you will see the UISP switch connected, and it gives us a speed of 1 gig between each radio or each access point. And this is the correspondence stations it's working with. Okay, if you come to tower 2, it's the same thing happening here. You see the various network speeds between the various access points. So basically that is it with the topology. Okay, so you see this coverage heat maps. Okay, so it tells you how good and quality the signals would be at particular points. The same thing is happening here. The topology tells you the network architecture of what you've designed on the map. If you come downwards, so this is where the price is being calculated for you. All the access points that were selected automatically according to the tool is going to give you the total cost of what you need to pay. Then you check out. And then the last thing is a profitability calculator. So it tells you the downlink and uplink, okay, and the price per month. So it tells you the benefit of deploying these access points and the revenue you can generate from it. I mean from them. Okay, so basically this is how this ISP design center works, and it will help a lot of ISPs. It will help a lot of them. You know, it's a very smart tool which will make your work very easy. So I encourage more RF deployment engineers and ISPs to hook up to this tool and use it for their maximum benefit, for it to help them a lot, right? Hi folks, we've come to the end of this video. I believe and I trust you know how to deploy this particular tool to help you with regards to your RF connection deployments. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to like, share my videos, and comment on my videos as well. Thank you for watching.